The purpose of vulnerability management is not to manage vulnerabilities. What activities are involved in vulnerability management? Your goal must not be to address the largest possible number of the issues that you encounter. Hi, this is Carsten from Hacking Matters, where each week we explore the pitfalls of cybersecurity. Today we look at vulnerability management. A lot of mistakes stand around this topic, as well as some ideas on how to do it right. Vulnerability management is one of five core security processes, as we looked at in another video. Of the five, it's probably the worst understood. Starting with the name. The purpose of vulnerability management is not to manage vulnerabilities, but rather to manage other processes, namely patching, hardening, identity management, network segregation, and similar processes where security should arise from. So vulnerability management looks at the outcome of these processes and gives feedback if the processes fail. But one step back, what activities are involved in vulnerability management? Everything starts with collecting data, either through scans across the network, for instance, or by collecting data on your assets. Hardening checks, for instance, cloud asset checks, any number of checks embedded in your CI/CD pipeline, all of those give you valuable information that goes into vulnerability management and basically lists of vulnerabilities. And a broken vulnerability management process stops there, says, we collected all of this data, let's send it out. Let's make people aware of the vulnerabilities on their systems. But that's not vulnerability management, that is vulnerability distribution. As a second step after collecting data, you want to map vulnerabilities to issues, basically symptoms to root causes. Let's say you encounter a missing patch in some middleware component. That's a symptom. The issue is that your patch management wasn't complete enough or fast enough to deploy the patch before your scanner encountered the gap. You want to investigate, what does our middleware patching regime look like? Is it fast enough? Is it complete enough? And often you discover that, for instance, a new middleware component has been deployed that the patch management isn't even aware of yet. So that's a process issue, not a vulnerability. And vulnerability management can fix that process issue and never make the vulnerabilities go away over time. If instead you're just dishing out lists of issues, those lists are growing without really pointing to the root causes. And often that activity goes nowhere. And then there's a third step after scanning and mapping to root causes. And that is focusing on those issues that you can reasonably address and accepting the others. Management is always around trade-off choices. And if you're encountering issues that are just impossible to address right now, there's really no point making people aware of those same issues again and again and again within a time frame that they said they couldn't fix the issues anyway. So you want to look at the risk acceptance, issue the permission to leave these vulnerabilities open for a certain amount of time, and only then revisit them after whatever prerequisite has been created in addressing those types of issues. So between those three activities, you're creating a lot of issues, you're reducing the set of issues to root causes, and then you're reducing the list of root causes further by accepting some of them. So you can really focus on a small set of addressable issues at any point in time. And with these three activities, scanning, mapping to root causes, and accepting the root causes that you cannot currently address, you create a management loop, a feedback loop that can help these other processes become better over time and thereby reduce the number of issues that you encounter through vulnerability management over time. That must be your goal. Your goal must not be to address the largest possible number of the issues that you encounter. Rather, you gotta be one step more ambitious and say, our goal is for those issues to not exist in the first place. Manage vulnerability root causes rather than forward lists of vulnerabilities. In terms of technology, your vulnerability management will continue to evolve. You have your baseline scanner that scans across the network, maybe does authenticated scans as well, on standard IT components, your servers, maybe your network equipment. But as you're extending into the cloud, for instance, you have more specialized scanners that enumerate issues in Google Cloud or AWS. Often you can actually download those issues more or less for free from the cloud dashboards that those providers already give you. As you're moving into more agile deployment practices, you have additional opportunities to put security checks, fully automated security checks, into those deployment stages, scanning the source code as it's being committed, scanning the containers as you're putting them together in your Artifactory, scanning the containers again in the live environment. All of this is possible with standard hooks or relatively affordable tools and gives you additional lists of vulnerabilities. So as your tool set keeps growing, it becomes even more important to be able to prune down those lists of vulnerabilities onto root causes and then focus on the root causes that really matter. So that you're only focusing on a few battles at a time and battles you're likely to win. I hope these thoughts help you focus on where it matters. We have additional videos on the other processes you want to influence: patching, hardening, identity management, network segregation around the topic of zero trust. So do check out these as well. And if any additional requests of what you would like for us to discuss, let us know below. Until next time, happy hacking.